And we know that the apostles have the option not to forgive. Because when I've mentioned this to non-Catholics, they've sometimes said, well, God will forgive your sins anyway. But actually, these verses show that there's no guarantee that God will forgive sins. Because when Jesus says, if you retain the sins of any, they are retained, that means that the apostles here could hear somebody's confession and decide, say, it's not sincere, or the person doesn't intend to change. And so they could say, well, I'm not giving you forgiveness. Or as we Catholics say, I'm not giving you absolution. That is, I'm not absolving you of your sins. And given that that's a possibility, no Christian, nobody who calls himself a Christian, should ever presume that everything that he does is forgiven by God. And this then, this is kind of the launching pad for widening out the whole discussion into the question of the Protestant belief that you are guaranteed salvation. Because the Protestant belief that you're guaranteed salvation is predicated upon the idea that no matter what you do as a Christian, God forgives you and you're guaranteed going to heaven. But from the words of Jesus in John's Gospel in chapter 20, since an apostle could retain a sin, that is, refuse to forgive it, then there's clearly no guarantee of forgiveness. You can't be certain that you'll be forgiven. And so there's no guarantee of salvation. And therefore that pillar of the Protestant religion falls away and shows Protestantism to be in deep error. So we must not say, I've got an assurance of salvation. Because Scripture makes clear that there is no assurance of salvation. That then is the words of Jesus